Hello, Yasina.
Hello, Maria Rita.
Thank you for being a yes to practicing being centered and staying centered. And being centered is about being in your power. Because when you are centered, that is when you are here, present, with a small now. And from this place, it is when you can connect with your inner resources, with, for example, your intuition, your feelings, your power to ask, declare, your power to choose, your power to say yes, no. And when you are not centered, it means that your center, your energetic center, is with someone else or something else or elsewhere than here now with you in your together with your inner your physical center. And when your energetic center is elsewhere, it means that you are being adaptive, playing small, playing safe, and you are in reaction. You are in reaction to something or someone else. As opposite of being in action, in integrity to who you are. And to be centered, you bring your energetic center together with your physical center. And your physical center is in your physical body, and it is the point of gravity of your physical body. Imagine if you were on your body was balancing on something. Your physical center is where your physical body would be in balance. And your physical center is about three fingers under your belly button, between your hip bones. Between your belly and your back. So it is not on your belly, it's in between your body. And it is static, it does not move. This is the place it is. And your energetic center does move. And it not only moves, it also can be spread at the same time in different places. It can be, for example, in the past, in the future, in your head. With different people. It can also be with a conversation you have not finished or some job unfinished, what you are going to do after this call we are having right now. And to be centered, which is to bring your energetic center together with your physical center, you use your intention, which is your conscious anger also. You need your conscious anger to use your intention to bring your energetic center to your physical center, which is called then being centered, which means that you are in your authority and in your power. And only you can do this. So nobody or nothing can take your center from you. Only you can give your center. And only you can take your center back. And you can do this at any time, in any moment. And to do this, you need to have access to your conscious anger, as I said. And it is not something that happens in your imagination. It is not a concept, something you think of and you imagine. It is a sensation, it is an experience that you have. And it is an energetic muscle, your energetic, bringing your energetic center is an energetic muscle that you need to train. Because you have not learned as you grew up to train your energetic muscle to bring your energetic center with your intention to your physical center. Do you have any questions?
Yes. I'm noticing that before PM, I had a way of centering. And then being in touch with PM, it's quite visual for me. And yeah, my mind sometimes makes it mean that it should be a certain way of how I've learned it in, yeah, in the possibility management commodity. And I'm curious. Yeah, I would love to do this exercise with you to experience centering with your clarity.
And you say that you use images, different images to center yourself. Yes. And there are different practices for centering, which some can be more experiential. They are all experiential, and some use more images. And they can be useful, these images. And the point I want to make is that it is not only staying in the images or in the the idea, in the concept of it, that will make you be centered. It can support you going through this experience of being centered. So there are different tools. Also, using images can be a tool to support you growing the muscle of being centered.
Thank you.
Okay, so I'll ask you to stand up. And great. And make connection with your physical center, which is this place in the middle of your body. Three fingers under your belly button, between your hip bones, between your belly and your back. Yes, and putting your hand there often helps. And just take some time to make connection with this place. And make an X so I can cross in your physical center. So you have this reference point. And now notice where your attention is, because where your energetic center is also where your attention is. And notice all the different places it is, and take your time and name them out loud as you go.
Okay. My attention is with you. My attention is on the sounds of my surroundings, the cars driving past on the road. My attention is in my middle back, where I feel some tightness. And now my attention is more in the center of my body.
And notice if you also have anything in the past or in the future or in your head.
Yeah, a little bit. Now you mention the past. Yes. It's with a hitchhiker who I had an awesome conversation with. But mainly my attention is with you, listening to you, and and trying to keep my attention here.
So you don't need to do anything for now besides noticing the places where your attention is. And notice now in your physical center, imagine let it be a big magnet, like these magnets you put on the fridge. Let it be a big magnet, grow into a grapefruit size magnet. And you'll need to raise your anger slightly, your conscious anger, to also declare a magnet in your physical center. And this magnet will now pull all the pieces of your energetic center that are spread into your physical center. So with your intention, you will pull all these pieces to your physical center. Yes. And let me know when they are all there.
Yeah, it's just between me and you. So it's still also on you, but maybe 30%.
Yeah, so bring also all of your energetic center, all of it to your own physical center. And you'll need some of your conscious anger, about 10% of your attention, to stay centered, to keep your center. How is it going?
Yeah, I'm about 90% there.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, and relax your shoulders also. To be centered is not to be rigid. Yeah. Yeah, and now stay in connection with me while you keep your center. And I will ask you now a question. Did something happen to your center just as I said this?
Yes.
What happened?
Well, there was fear. I was aware of some fear, and like what I saw was a bit bigger. So there was more attention on you.
Yeah. So grab your center again. Grab your, with the magnet you have, keep this magnet pulling it back. I will ask you a question, and let me know what happens also with your center as I ask you a question. What is happening right now with your center?
It's sort of in my chest and in my belly, in my chest and my belly.
Yeah, so bring your hand to your belly. So you can also have a little bit of pressure. So it will support the tension being there in your physical center. Yes. Yes. And when you're ready, open your eyes and stay in connection. And the skill is to stay centered and be in connection, because gremlin can also fake being centered by going rigid or putting a wall. And then I can pretend I am centered, nothing is impacting me, but then nothing is coming through. So the skill to grow is you're centered and you are in connection and not in reaction. And then whatever comes from the outside can touch you. And then you can respond. Respond from your authentic impulses. Yosina, how does it go? How would it look like if you had all your needs met?
I sense
bring
my
your center from your head down to your physical center again.
I sense that all my needs were met, my energetic body would be big.
How big?
Oh, like a size of New Zealand. And I would sit here like a Buddha, just like, yeah. Be.
So, tell me more, like how would it look like? And you're searching in your head again. So bring your center back to your physical center.
What it would look like is moving at my inner speed. It would be mostly slower than what I normally do. And yet, if something were to fall, it would just be the ability to, you know, be present everywhere at once would be there. It would be like being so present that I would feel changes around me and observe them. I would have an awareness of them. It would be like a free flow of my impulses. My impulses would be so audible, so visible, so tangible. Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you for having this exploration.
Thank you.
Yeah. And we will end now this centering practice. Do you have anything to comment or ask?
No, not right now. Thank you.
Thank you, Yosina.
Thank you, Maria Rita.